Boom.
Nice hat.
Excellent. Welcome. I know it's not on the overlay. You'd never be able to tell what's actually going on here, but clearly this is Worldwide Wrestling RPG One Shot with these fine folks joining us. Because so much of this game involves the audience, I will be including chat on the overlay. So if you have terrible things to say about really anything tonight, shut your face, because I'll be judicious in the use of bans. Super judicious. If you're watching on YouTube, say all the terrible things you want, because I'll just delete your comments. Let's talk about who we have here, where you can find them, and what they do. In the meantime, I'll be posting in chat all of the cool stuff you'll need to follow along. Well, we always start with the most experienced player. Given that no one here has any experience with the system, I'm gonna start with Sid Alpha. Why don't you tell us about yourself there, Rich?
Well, boys and girls, as you might know, I am a YouTuber. I do video game reviews, first impressions, gaming news, and things of that nature. I'm also on Arthur's channel here as often as humanly possible, just making a general nuisance out of myself and usually doing a pretty good job of it. Aside from that, this is I think this is going to be pretty interesting. I've never done any form of gaming system like this before in the history of ever. So this is going to be a very new experience for me. Aside from that, yeah, I'm still on my quest for 1,000 subs, getting ever closer. Looks like it will happen in about a weekish at the current rate. And then I will be completely and utterly insufferable for everyone.
Our channel goals are so opposed. Like, my Twitch page is all about spreading happiness through the candle flame, and you're just like, all right, Jim Sterling, it's time to take
power.
You down. What's that? Another nasty review to write about Star Citizen? Guess that game's never going to get published.
Give me all of the power.
So, Riga, I have played with you, even if you haven't been on the show before. Let's talk about you. Where can people find you, and what do you do?
I'm Australian, and I annoy people on Twitch streams. That's about it.
Incredibly descriptive.
Yeah, that is incredibly descriptive. But yeah, I finally get to annoy you on your channel, like, in the game. It's brilliant, rather than just the chat, so it'll be an interesting experience. As far as wrestling, like, I haven't thought about wrestling in so many years, and then you're like, hey, do you want to do this? And you've reawoken my wrestlingness, and suddenly I fell back into it like I could remember everything. Yeah. So you corrupted me again, AP.
About it.
Yeah, it's just like, you're like, do you want to do wrestling? I'm like, yeah, sure, let's do that. That sounds cool. And then it's like, oh, wrestling. I'll check out a video so I'm up to date. Wait, this is awesome. Wait, what am I doing? Ah, why, I know everything. So, yeah.
Yeah. Cottontailed, I'm sure a lot of people know you or have heard your name, but it's your first time on the show. Why don't you tell us where people can find you? Who you are and what you do, besides draining the blood from poor, unsuspecting mortals.
Yes. Well, I usually tell them that I'm going to draw their blood. They're expecting it.
Usually.
Well, you can find me on cottontailed@twitter.com and Sharky, it's Sharky's channel where I play with Riga sometimes.
Yeah.
That's about it.
Yeah,
sometimes I draw fan art. That's all I do.
Yeah, that crazy fan art. Good. Really good. I still don't know who this pie character is, but they wear a chicken on their head, so it's all good, right? Pie with a sword, where she's like, bam, I got a sword. I'm like, man, nice hair. Also, that's a sword. Yeah, I am, of course, Arthur Perkins, AP Gaming Real, and I am creative tonight. I don't just mean that as a descriptive of my amazing talents, but I am playing the character of creative, which is to say, I am everything else. Yeah, and we're going to be playing through a one-shot of Worldwide Wrestling RPG. So, let's be clear here. You, the audience, watching live, sorry, YouTube, get screwed. I can't help you here. If you're not present, you can't participate. Those of you who are here and are not on YouTube watching live can participate by picking which wrestlers you want to see in which fights, and who wins those fights. Because the players will not know who's going to win whatever match they're in until I reveal it midway through. So yeah, let's talk
Chat gets
about...
Chat gets Sokol to finish? Wow.
Let's talk about...
That'll be fun.
I'm going to lose every match.
I was just thinking
Don't
the same
think like
thing.
Like that.
I mean,
nah,
you're going to have to
cut every time.
To a jobber.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's talk about the first episode, which is what we're basically going through. Everyone will need to have picked a gimmick. Now, I've helpfully placed your gimmick name next to your character name on the stream. However, a lot of people watching this stream apparently just listen to voices, so I'm going to ask everyone to introduce their character, your gimmick, your name, and your general look, all from your gimmick sheet. So who wants to go first? Don't all jump at once.
Everyone jump on that. Yeah.
Riga, you
I will
in.
Go
I
first.
Volunteered. Let's do it.
Yeah, sure. I'll do it. I'm playing The Wasted. You are well-known for your impressive style and have a dedicated fan base, but you have some serious real-life substance abuse and addiction problems that could threaten your career. As far as how he looks... very standard wrestler type, but pants rather than tights, like big sort of baggy pants. Probably some sort of like a running shoe because it's for what he has to do. Elbow pads, and he has long sort of think edge, blonde hair, long blonde hair. Very anemic looking addict sort of thinness with muscle because otherwise he'd die. Predominantly painkillers because of the crazy stuff he has to do. He believes, beyond a shadow of a doubt, the only reason he's famous is because he continuously does bigger and bigger stunts and is slowly destroying himself to continue that rise, and he thinks without it he will fail and not have a career anymore.
You're like Dr. House.
Kind of. Yeah, he lives for the holy shit chant. That's all he does. Like, he truly believes if he can't continue topping himself and one-upping himself, he'll fail. And fall out of relevance.
And what was your name again?
Crash Williams, the unkillable Crash Williams.
Yeah, good stuff. The unkillable Crash Williams. All right, who wants to go next?
I will go. My character this evening will be Rob Ripper Johnson. Rob stands a towering 7 feet tall, weighs approximately 400 pounds. As with every wrestler, he tends to be a bit on the muscular side. His classic coloring motif is, of course, black and red shorts. He does wear a mask as well to cover his hideously scarred face from frightening small women and children.
Okay.
Such a sexist. I sound like I'd be afraid of him.
Sounds like a scary dude.
Yeah.
And he is, of course, the gimmick I'll be using for him is the monster.
The monster. Yeah.
The monster.
He's allegedly
mostly
well
because
over 300 pounds.
He outweighs me crazy.
Yeah, Cotton, why don't you tell us a little bit about your character?
I'm playing Kaya, the queen of the Amazon. She's dressed like an Amazon warrior with, like, the warrior face paint instead of a mask. I'm playing a high flyer, which is you're extremely athletic and able to go to the top rope and execute dazzling maneuvers. You put your body on the line every night. How long can you keep this up? And she stands about 6 feet tall. Black hair.
So I had an idea when I was putting the NPW list, the non-player wrestlers, together, that it would all be like modern event gimmicks, like a Donald Trump wrestler and like... Marvel superhero wrestlers. Are you a gimmick that's like Wonder Woman from the new Batman vs. Superman gimmick? Are you like a play on that?
I haven't
are
seen
you
that
your
yet.
Own person?
My own person.
we do need some Roxy Crash up in here. All right. So
I'm glad someone picked an actual like character. Like I picked an crazy asshole, and Rich picked just a giant. Scary person, and then we have an actual character with that.
Don't worry, your NPWs will all be total stereotypes because I don't have time to make up original characters. I'm going to be recycling people from the last time I ran this.
It's like wrestling's cliche or something.
Yeah, we're gonna do some nitty gritty specifics for each character now. Who wants to break their character down for a little while?
In regards to
yeah. thanks, Rich, for volunteering. Where do you hail from, and what is your entrance?
Rob hails from parts unknown. It's never been explained where he's come from, where he comes from, or why he's here. His entrance type is always weird and mysterious. He has a tendency to just randomly appear out of nowhere.
Nice.
Usually right behind his unsuspecting opponent.
All right.
The whole place goes dark.
Let's talk about your stats. What are you throwing down in there, Mr. Monster?
Well, for... I chose the intimidating and not of this world stats, which provides me a finishing of look, which is a look of 0. I end up with a power of +2, reel of -2, and work of -1.
All right. So when you're not in the ring, you use your power instead of your look.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Which I figured would be extremely fitting, given his extreme size.
You have a starting audience score. Starting by placing a check mark next to the number indicated by this gimmick starts within resets to you. So, you start with 1 audience level. The audience kind of likes you, but you need to throw a little bit more in there. Alright, Ripper. +1 audience. Excellent. Who's next for, you know, just... talking about yourself, you know, say whatever you want. Crash, any chance I can tempt you?
Sure. Remind me again, how many of the moves do we pick? I know that we had forever to read over this book, but I've blanked
for a second. For instance, for Monster, it says, and pick 2. Let's look at Wasted. Okay. Wasted says, pick 1, because you have the attic move.
Oh, do I start with the addict move? Okay. Yep. I was going to do the one that overrides addict, which is completely insane. Replace any stat with look when you do something that's just plain crazy. This overrides addict. If you botch, you injure yourself.
Ooh, good stuff.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he added his +1 to look. So he's at look 2, power -1, real -2, and work 0.
Wow. Yeah, you're not going to be very good at picking people up and slamming them down, but you can cut a promo.
Yeah, and he hails from the edge of reality.
What's his entrance like?
His entrance is very intense and showy, so it's it starts out with some intense rock drums with flashing white and black. Like, I like to think they put a seizure warning on the show for his entrance, just for the first few seconds.
Really?
And then the big, yeah, just bang, 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 and then he comes out with, like, the big column sparklers, like, the big column, like, towers of pyro, and does like his sort of wings pose that he does, which is like a crucifix pose, and then like does the big sprint down to the ring and slide in, and then a pose in the middle, and there we go.
Excellent. It looks like you start with an audience score of 1 right there.
No, Waster starts with a recessed audience +2.
Are we looking at the same one?
Yeah, it's under, so rest, injury, audience advancement, audience, the Wasted starts and resets to audience +2.
I have a +1 here, man.
That's interesting. I was going off the book you gave me, you pick. But he does have, like, the in his
background. Oh, you know what, you're right.
Yeah.
You're right. I don't know why it says 2 different things earlier in the thing, but yeah. All right, Wasted. Start with 2. Perfect. Everybody loves you. It's not going to take much work for you to get over the top and be... head of the card. All right, Kaya, tell us about the Amazon.
What do you want to know first?
Let's talk about where you're from, what your entrance is like, where you put the stats, and what moves you're throwing down.
She's from Daytona Beach, Florida.
So the only person from an actual place. Got it.
Yeah.
But she's probably not from. I can almost guarantee that.
Her entrance is always to Welcome to the Jungle. It always starts playing. And she comes out doing flips and stuff, and maybe sometimes, like, swings onto the stage on a vine, Tarzan style.
That's awesome.
And for my moves, I picked Fan Favorite, and look at that amazing athleticism.
What do those do for you?
Fan favorite is, you know what they want to see when you make a big deal of being passed over roll plus reel on a 10 plus pick 2 on a 7 and 9 pick 1. Demand and be granted. On a match, gain plus 1 heat with the one side lining you and gain plus 1 momentum. On a botch, you lose 1 audience.
Okay.
And then look at the amazing athleticism as plus 1 work.
So what did your stats end up being with that work bonus?
With the work bonus, it's look 0, power minus 2, reel minus 1, and work plus 2.
Awesome.
Oh, look is 1. I added that to the, yeah.
All right. So now we need to break it down to the even nittier and the even grittier, right? Now we have everybody's characters. We know who they are and where they're from, but we don't know how they interact with each other, and that's important. We're going to be doing something called generating heat, and heat is an indicator of how much the audience likes watching two different wrestlers together, right? You could have two mm-hmm. greatest wrestlers in the world. You put them in the ring together, and if no one gives a crap, everyone's just going to be like, yay, go Undertaker, and I don't know, Jihad Jim. Can't wait for that guy to get buried. When's the next match start?
Don't he will actually get buried.
Oh boy. Yeah. So, let's talk about heat. Each of you has a few heat questions here. You will ask a question to another player. So, oh, I'm sorry. You will ask one question per the number of players that we have. Someone will answer it, and when they do, get plus one heat with that person. So, for instance, if Riga wanted to be a jerk face, he could answer all the questions from one person, and the two of them would have a lot of heat with each other, and the other person would have zero heat and be very sad.
I don't think that's a problem, just to peek behind the curtain. You know, backstage, we've all been talking crap to each other for about 3 weeks, so... Yeah,
this is true.
We all want to beat the hell out of each other just as much as anyone else.
So, this is... I'm going to ask, who wants to go first to ask a question to someone else? Like a chain
I'll do it.
Questioning. All right, Crash.
I'll go.
Let's do this.
Yeah. So, do you want to just start, go down from the top, or just pick one?
Pick whichever one you want. You only get to ask two questions, so make them count.
All right. Let's do. Who is jealous of my fan base?
I'll be jealous.
Oh. What's Good. That about?
I don't think he deserves his fans if he's always wasted.
Ripper cares like not for your pitiful fans.
I think I'm like the crap version of Cotton. She does like these stylistic moves and it works. I like fuck them up and crash through tables and shit and wreck myself repeatedly. So I'm her, but I don't do it as well and I still have a better audience. What?
No, you have the same level of audience, but she just wants...
No, but I just mean narratively.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Interesting. Okay, so, Ripper, you have one heat with Amazon now. Got another question for us?
Wouldn't that be Crash? Whatever.
Yes, Crash. Sorry, Crash. I better correct that on this sheet so that I do not get that wrong.
So do I do a second question or are you going to go around?
No, take your second question. Go ahead.
Okay, I'll ask this leading question, wondering who's going to pick it. Who kicked my ass backstage most recently?
I have a feeling that would have to be Ripper.
Tell us about it.
Don't say.
What's the beef between you two?
I have a feeling that Crash messed up one of his stunts, and he's the reason why Ripper's face is scarred.
Ooh, that's good.
So how did beatdown commence? Like, walk us through the specifics.
Oh, can we do it? Can we go old school, really brutal, and do it with a botched thumbtack spot? Because that's really old school hardcore.
Botched what?
I don't know what that is.
When they used to throw thumbtacks down, and they'd get slammed onto it on their back, which would hurt a lot.
Wow,
but if you wore it the wrong way...
Shit.
That was a real thing. Go Google some Mick Foley stuff, people.
Okay.
That doesn't sound safe at all.
Down to that.
It's not safe at all. Either that or we do the flaming tables spot and we burn your face. Pick one.
I think the thumbtack one would be better because I believe I think the scarring is actually in character.
It, it would also go away because like the wounds wouldn't actually be that bad. It would just hurt a lot on the time.
Yeah. So how did you beat him down backstage, Ripper?
Just happened to catch him away from his posse and gave him what for?
He totally put me through the he like powerbombed me through the like the catering table.
Not the catering table.
How dare you?
It's always good.
Oh yes, put him through the catering table and then sat on him munching away on with shrimp.
Smushed stuff into his face.
Yeah. All right. Who wants to ask some questions next? I asked.
I'll ask some questions.
Yeah. Let's talk about your questions, Monster. What do you want to say? I'm giving you the mic.
Let's see. Who's made me look weak?
I want to do it.
Okay.
Okay.
That's awesome.
How did that
happen? Thin little high flyer. Yes.
Get wrecked. I took him down really quick in a match, like within two moves.
Ooh.
Yes.
Was totally it intentional? Like was the pin. Boss
like a surprise attack or
cradle pin. Or you got distracted, just roll you up.
Yeah, make sure you lose to him and make it take super long. And you were like, nope, I'm just gonna annihilate him.
That one. For some reason he made me mad and I just annihilated him when I saw him in the ring. Didn't even give him a chance to react.
She broke kayfabe and booking and just went for a surprise attack, which actually surprised him. That's why he got pinned.
Cotton, what's your character's name again?
Kaya.
The Amazon.
Mm-hmm. I'm guessing that's K-A-I-A?
Yes.
I didn't see chat's response to the thumbtacks, but I'll have to read that.
And this is oddly ties in oddly well. Who is terrified of me backstage?
I wonder who it would be. It's me because I don't have anything. I don't have much to jump off of and not
technically
run away from.
Either one of you.
No, I'll take it. You beat the hell out of me, and now I don't want to run into you again. Seems fair.
Okay.
I'll fight you out there in the ring where I think I have an advantage, or at least some sort of advantage. It's not backstage where you can put me through a wall.
All right, I'll take that.
Oh, man, got to do some call-outs in chat real quick. Kaya, ask some questions, and I mean, I'll lie, but they can't, so.
Who wishes they could do what I could do, what I do?
Oh, I think that answer is really obvious.
Yeah, probably.
You've been talking some jelly shit all day.
Yeah, I wish I could manage to look as professional and smooth doing those kind of things, but my name's Crash. What do you want?
Obviously, you just got to change your gimmick and make your name something that's not Crash.
I have come up with three nicknames, one for people who like him, one for people who think he's crazy, one for people who hate him.
So much thought into this character.
It just happened naturally. I'm like, oh, that works, and that works.
You were telling me you wrote a theme song.
I did.
Yeah.
Are you going to sing it?
Probably not, but we'll see. That's exactly it. There's a lyric actually B-A-A-A, like ba-ba-da.
Your theme song is literally just a vocalized John Cena theme song. Perfect. Yeah, let's talk about your other question, Kaya.
Who always has my back?
Well, that's interesting. Well, I could jump in and say that, like, backstage I do, or unless Ripper wants another one and we just share it out evenly.
Actually, I'll take that one.
All right.
Yeah, go for it.
So after we're all even. Was this before or after she pinned you in the ring, embarrassing you and wrecking your championship title shot?
Oh, it was a title shot.
Actually, oddly really enough, after. She's Ooh. Won his respect.
Yeah, okay, interesting. Okay, so we got some heat. For anyone wondering, they all have one heat with each other. That was worked out. So,
we gotta compete
time,
for who's the best.
We need to make some assumptions here. You needed to make a decision as to whether you are a babyface or a heel. So that's whether you're a good guy character or a bad guy character. You, in chat talking to you now, not the players. I need you thinking about wrestlers that you want to see go up against each other. Right? Tell me about matches you want to see. Who wins that match? Start thinking. All right, who's a babyface? Who's a heel? Hit me with it.
Heel.
Oh, bad guy off the bat.
Babyface.
I'm... She's a babyface. And I'm currently a heel and not doing very well at it.
Oh, boy.
He's trying to be a heel, but it doesn't really work very well with his setup.
So I want to throw some MPWs, out there. For folks, I want to hear if you, the players, want to have them in the match today. Audience, you'll be able to set up matches with these folks. It sounds like James Jives will be making a comeback. I thought he died at the end of Friday Night Fights, but I guess he's still alive. Wasn't he, like, doing cocaine and Pepsi? He's still here.
Yeah, it was the Pepsi that
got him. Why is cocaine and Pepsi a dangerous combination?
I mean, he was just a shill, a sellout for the Pepsi Corporation while doing cocaine.
And the Colombian drug cartels.
We also have Scowling Scotty Proper making a comeback, and the Wizard. So Scowling Scotty Proper is a wrestler whose finishing move is called the Ancestor's Blow, which is a low-blow uppercut to hit people in their waistline genitals. He's an entertainer who brings comedy to the ring. He's frequently brought in as a guest referee, announcer, or participant to a fatal four-way or triple threat. He rarely wins, but always has the crowd. We also have the Wizard, whose finisher used to be Heat and Fire, and his name used to be the Wizard. He's now known as the Mechanical Master. He walks around with, like, a flock of drones around him. And occasionally uses his smartphone to have, like, the drones hit people while he's wrestling with them.
It's cool.
Yeah. I feel like he took this from, like, the South Park RPG or something. Like, jeez.
Yeah, so this is the Wizard, who people will recognize from Friday Night Fights, but he is now the Mechanical Master.
Yeah. He's gone for a new gimmick.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, my in-character gimmick is he plays a man who believes he is immortal and cannot die, and therefore is not afraid to do anything crazy. He gets hurt, but he believes he will not die.
That you can call yourself the Unkillable. The final wrestler we have tonight is Magical Michael.
by request.
Who was requested by Rinskaru, who's too sick to join us tonight. She had a character named Reese Magnum, who was Reese Magnum the Volatile? Volatile Reese Magnum, there we go. Who's going to join us, and she had wanted one of the Magic Mike characters to show up. And so this guy's name is Magical Michael, and his finishing move is called the Hardwood, which is when he takes somebody, puts them up on the ropes, and then body slams them into the announcer's table, and then keeps throwing them into it until the table cracks.
That seems
he's
fair.
He's a former adult entertainment provider who has become a wrestler, who only wears, what do you call it, boxer briefs with studded rhinestones.
Oh, jeez.
Yep. Magic Michael.
So you made Val Venus. Good. You made Val Venus. That's brilliant.
Man, I didn't want to put Mr. Ass on the line again.
Who I thought was Val Venus to begin with, so now we have two of them.
You want to be one of them rep? Okay, so we've got a couple of suggestions here in chat. All right. Yeah. All right. So I'm gonna go with the ones we see here immediately. That should last us until the first break, and then there'll be more time for the audience to decide on the next round of matches. Let me just.
Should we do finishes? Should we discuss what they are?
Yeah, let's talk about your finishers while I write some things down.
I want to know what Ripper picks.
Finishing moves. Fine.
Yeah, I'll go. Yeah. What I did was, as Chad has pointed out, I am very obviously based heavily on Jeff Hardy. So I wanted to make the Swanton Bomb and make it more stupid. So it is instead, it's a real move. It is called, in real life, the 630 Splash, which he calls the Fearless Plunge, which is essentially, you stand and do an entire front flip and a half, landing back first on someone. It's incredibly hard to do, requires a lot of torque, and when you do it off the top of a ladder, your aim is crap. This might also add to the fact that he horribly botches high spots when he tries to do this sometimes. it is an incredibly dangerous move to try.
Yeah. Kai, why don't you tell us about your finishing move?
I took mine from Rey Mysterio. Riga, what was it called again?
619.
It's a 619. Yeah.
619, yeah, when they go between the ropes and kick somebody. But at the end, she stands on the person and yells, "Now bow to your queen."
I like it.
So good. All right, Ripper, tell us about your probably terrifying finishing move.
Oh, you mean the tombstone?
Oh, of course. Oh, yes. Yes.
The tombstone basically involves a chair in someone's neck.
Oh.
We're going with fun.
Imagination.
I like it.
Perfect, perfect. All right, so let's see here. Just a reminder, if you want to keep heat with everybody that you already have, you don't necessarily have to gain heat in the episode, but if you want to keep the heat you have, you need to interact with them in some way during the show. You can do that by cutting a promo, by doing a run-in. So cutting a promo is when you take a mic and you speak your mind. That could be as simple as doing a pre-recorded session, or when you do your entrance, you stop and you give a short speech. Run-in is if you are really bored, or you just want to change the way a match is going, you can just be like, "I'm going to run in," and stop it. Yeah. So, keep an eye on your
keep an eye on your
momentum, and keep an eye on, if you get bored, run in. The final mechanic we need to discuss is the audience mechanic. Not the audience mechanic. The announcer mechanic. Whoever is not in a match, if there's more than one person, we'll have to pick between them, but whoever is not in a match will be doing the commentary for it. They'll be the one talking about how the moves go. And their own take on what's happening. But more importantly, they also have the option of putting over on either wrestler once per match. So they can be like, "Oh, your move failed. You didn't do good enough. I'm going to make it even better by being like, oh my gosh, did you see that through the table? It was amazing." And all everybody watching is like, "Wow, the table's not actually broken, but yeah."
Oh yeah, they do that really horrible finish where it's bang on the table and it looks worse. It looks like it hurts way more. And just doesn't give. Yeah, not good.
I think because of my character's nature with the mask and the scarring and everything, I think the announcer is an alter ego.
Yeah.
Like Jeff Johnson.
Jeff Johnson.
Well, you can do the thing with the mask. You do the thing where the mask has like dreads on it, but like they're actually on the mask, so when you take it off, it's like completely not your hair.
Yeah.
Chat's calling for a heel face team. Awesome.
All right. So each of you, I'll need you to check your gimmick sheets. Speaking of heat, your audience level will tell you how much momentum you start each match with. Keeping a momentum is important. You can spend momentum to boost your die rolls after they're dropped. So you can be like, "Oh, I only got a 6. I'm going to spend 1 point and bump it up to a 7.
So is your starting audience your starting heat? Is that what it...
No. So, let's see here. For Wasted, you start at 2 audience, and when you have 2 audience, you start the episode with 1 momentum.
Sweet.
Yes.
Basically, we all start with 1 momentum.
Yeah, we all start...
I think some of them get good momentum amounts, but yeah, it could be that.
I'd imagine the High Flyer gets an extra one just to do crazy stuff. But that's just... I don't know if that's true.
But do we have an High Flyer?
We do.
You do. That's...
Oh, you are?
I mean, Crash is a High Flyer as well, but in a totally different way. Unfortunately, you all start with 1 momentum. And you can build that and work it up. You definitely don't want to hit 0 momentum at any time, however. You'd best to avoid that unless it's the end of the match.
That means you're just rolling on naked dice, which, ouch.
Yeah, it's not great. So, let's talk about promos. So we come in on Wrestlecation, right? That's the name of this new program. Been going on for a while. It happens Sunday nights around 8 p.m. Eastern. And James Gives is there at the announcer's table, just sipping on a nice, cool Joja Blue. And as the camera zooms in on his soulless, dead eyes, because he's just in the hospital constantly. He might be the person that crashes buying his painkiller shroom, come to think of it.
Does anyone know if it's kayfabe or not? It's probably started and it's not kayfabe. It's not kayfabe.
Yeah. The big screen lights up with an advertisement, and then the people at home see it on their televisions as well. And it's a wrestler by the name of Julius Orange, who's clearly a Donald Trump impersonator. And he's holding up a can of Joja Blue, and he's like, we've got the Joja Blue here. This is so good. Everybody loves it. Buy Joja Blue today, and you can help make Peloton Town greater. You know, Stardew Valley, all this stuff out here. Look around. This is the American heartland here. Okay? Joja Blue. Everyone loves it. Here, kid, have some Joja Blue. And he just throws the can and hits the kid in the side of the head. The kid just... He does that thing. Where it's obvious that in the first shot of the camera that it was a real person, and when the can hits them, they've been replaced by a doll that just falls over.
All I can picture is the Hot Fuzz scene where the guy's running away and he nails him with the spray can from across the field.
Yeah. And Julius Orange is just like, making America great again. Who wants to cut a promo next? And this can either be like a highlight reel from some previous match that you've done, or it can be you doing a live call out of another wrestler if you want to try to build some hype. It can be you talking to the audience directly, or if this is your first time wrestling. It doesn't sound like this anybody is like premiering for the first time, so we can skip that part. But yeah, who wants to step up and dance?
I'd like to think that Crash is actually returning from injury, as he does a lot. So it'd be a mix of, like, a pre-recorded spot with mixed in with, like, highlights of stuff he's done. Like, he's still relevant,
like,
right?
Like, it's like you talking about stuff, and then sometimes it's just you voiceovering, like, flying through the air as you're like, yeah, chair smash!
Yeah, so it'll start out... we'll start out in like a house party, like it's like teens and stuff dancing to music, and then like someone will fly through a skylight and just smash into the ground, and it goes real quiet, and we can't see the obvious crash mat that person landed on behind the table, and then I'll like come spinning in doing my actual finishing move, and then stand up from behind the table and go, "Sorry to crash the party. You thought I was gone, but no." I'm back. And then, like, the music will cut in, and it'll be, like, quick cuts of him jumping off, like, heaps of crazy ladders and stuff. Like, it'll be all these ridiculous highlights from pay-per-views, like, his massive spots. And it'll be like, nothing can kill me. Not even God can kill me. I always come back. And this time, oh, you have no idea. And it's all, like, dark music and rock music coming through. And then it'll start going to more brutal shots of him, like, hitting people with chairs. And it's clearly going for a darker angle. He's trying to do his heel character come through.
Cool.
See if people want him to return as a heel.
Why don't you roll your look, and we'll see how the people like it.
Yeah.
Make Stardew Valley great again, 2016.
Roll plus look. Oh, I need a time. Wow. So what do I roll? It's 2d6 plus 2.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll just add the plus 2. So it's a 4 plus 2, it's a 6. No one likes it.
Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's brutal.
Yep. No one wants to see him be healed.
Nobody cares that you're back.
Yeah.
He's back again. He does this a lot.
Yeah, this is bad for you, buddy. It's real bad.
It is. Yep.
So I think the audience sees you as like this complete sellout now, that you're just like doing whatever you need to like get back in the scene, and they're like telling James Gives to do something, and they cut back to James like, and James Gives like, We're back again. I'm James Jives, coming to you from the Pepsi Cola Arena here with the new Pepsi Cola Joja Blue. Ever since the merger of Pepsi and Joja Corporation, we're pleased to offer Joja Blue, a new Pepsi format.
Yeah, totally cut to commercial. he's come back from injury so many times.
Just got word from management. It turns out we're going to have an extra booking match tonight. Crash Williams will be partaking in a second match. It's going to be him versus Orange Julius. And everyone's like, oh, yeah, Julius is going to smash him.
No, I assume people are sick of Crash coming back every few months.
Yeah.
After he just destroys himself.
I'm out of the hospital, guys. I'm done with the drugs.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm still alive. Nothing can kill me.
I think at that point it cuts to a camera that's kind of being shaken as someone's walking backwards very hurriedly, and you see this towering giant hulk of a man wearing a red and black mask holding the microphone, and he's talking as he's stalking along and Crash, I'm glad you're back. You scarred this face, and for that, one beating isn't good enough for you. You think you're immortal? I'm going to prove to you that you're not. Tonight, you and me.
Ooh,
and he throws the microphone at the cameraman and keeps on walking past.
Someone trying to be a bad guy does awful, like, and then the real bad guy shows up.
Yeah, the cameraman's name is Sanjay. The audience really loves this guy. He, like, gets hit with the microphone, and there's, like, a noise, and he's like, oh, why did you hit me with the microphone, Mr. Ripper? This equipment is very expensive. and then it comes out. Yeah, why don't you roll some luck, and we'll see how the audience takes your beyond the grave pronouncement of Crash's doom.
Well, like thanks to my intimidation factor, I'll actually be rolling power on this.
Sweet, nice.
Oh,
so yes,
nice. Let's talk about it. Yeah, so you get some stuff here, right? You get to 7 and 9. You get to pick one. May create a book you in a match, add a stipulation to a relevant match, gain plus one momentum, and gain plus one heat with the subject of your promo. So to tell you what the matches are that are on the books right now, it is Magical Michael versus the Amazon, Ripper versus the Unkillable, and Crash versus Julius Orange, just in case you wanted to add any stipulations or heat.
He comes back from injury, wrestles twice.
Yeah.
No, I want to add Ripper and Crash to the booking.
Ripper and Crash are on the booking. Yep.
Make it a hardcore match. Beat the hell out of me.
Williams.
Huh?
Yep, you're already on.
Yeah, make it a stipulation. Like, beat the hell out of me. Change the match. Make it like a...
You want to build it up.
Oh, stipulation is I get to enter in a method of my choosing.
Ooh.
Oh, man. That sounds pretty terrifying.
So I have to walk out to the ring and just wait and see what happens?
You're just going to show up behind him, coming out of the coffin that was underneath the... Yeah, okay. All right, you add a stipulation in the match. Perfect. Let me just write that down. Match stipulated. Ripper does what he wants. Awesome. Kaya, before you're like promo plays for about half a second, and then it's replaced by another promo for Scowling Scotty Proper, like the cameraman got him out of order. And it's just Scowling Scotty Proper wearing only a kilt and nothing else, like doing some twerking and occasionally like see his ass underneath it. It's like 30 seconds of him twerking and then doing like crab walking back and forth, and then he turns around towards the camera and is like, "Hey, Scotty's back!" And everyone in the audience is like, "Yay, Scotty's back! And I'm going to find somebody and take him down!" And everyone in the audience is like, "She's about to say the thing!" And some guy's like, "Proper!" And everyone's like, "Shut the hell up." And he's like, "I'm gonna do it proper!" And everyone's like, "Yes, Scowling Scotty Proper!"
Awesome. Oh my gosh.
And then Kaya, the rest of your promo plays with like the first second cut out of it.
It starts out showing a bunch of highlights of me pinning people. Obviously, the Ripper isn't there like three times, that quick pin.
It's the same scene, but from a different angle.
Just a different camera.
Yeah. Cut.
And then she appears like in the jungle, but we couldn't find a jungle, so it's just artfully placed potted plants. And she goes, I am queen of the Amazon, and now I've come to show these men that I'm going to be queen of the WWE. And it just ends right there.
Oh, okay.
Ooh, well, cold
let's
open.
See if the audience likes that pronouncement.
Like, who is pot plant lady? I wanted you to have a big... I wanted you to have a snake prop that's clearly, like, made of rubber.
That's what she wants. She just throws the snake at you. And snake, you're like, yes. Oh, it's so real! I'm dying! Yeah, 7 to 9. You get to make some decisions here. What do you want to do?
I don't remember what I can do.
Let's see here. I think I have the link for this. Right? Yes, I do. I'll throw it in Roll 20. It should be working. It's been working on and off all night. But it's the cut a promo move.
Got it.
So you can make creative book you in a match, add a stipulation to a relevant match, gain +1 momentum, or gain +1 heat with the subject of your promo. And it sounds like Ripper is the subject of your promo.
I want 1 momentum, though.
Okay, cool. You're going to start off hot, hot, hot as, what was that guy's name from Fifth Element? Ruby Red? Man, he is the best. Yeah, so the first
the radio guy?
Yeah.
With the crazy blonde thing?
That was so good. Everyone's talking about, like, Hell in a Cell and all that stuff. We're only on the first day of matches, guys. Chill.
We, like, probably just came off a pay-per-view. This is cooldown. This is where people are coming back and stuff. And we're introducing new characters and trying to get new feuds.
Yeah, so the first match is Scowling Scotty Proper versus the Mechanical Master. And Scowling Scotty Proper enters the ring and is just, like, throwing up the devil horns everywhere and talking about how he's refreshed himself with his time in the home motherland, getting in touch with Satan, and everyone's like, this is a new thing. Like, I'm not sure I'm behind this shift. And the Mechanical Master, as we know, the wizard is always found in the audience, like, reading a book. Mechanical Master, they, like, finally find him with the spotlights in the audience, and he's, like, on his smartphone. And there's, like, a drone with a bag of popcorn, and it delivers it to him, and he takes it. And maybe maybe there's, like, a quick commercial for Amazon that's, like, PIP in the upper right-hand corner for, like, the Amazon drone delivery service that's playing. And he just like, looks at the camera, and he's like, oh, it's me, the Mechanical Master. Have I mentioned how much I like the Amazon drone delivery service? I buy all of my drones that I need to master from Amazon. Consider checking out Amazon Prime today and subscribing. He's, like, walking down to the ring, just looking at his smartphone, not watching where he's going. And people are, like, throwing stuff at him. Someone hits him with a hot dog, and everyone's like, we hate you! Go back to New York!
New York has power.
The match goes down much as you'd expect for one of the people in the match carrying a cell phone. Scowling Scotty Proper is continually putting the Mechanical Master in, like, leg locks. The whole time, the Mechanical Master is sending his army of drones to, like, run into Scowling Scotty Proper. But at one point, he, like, reaches up and grabs one and just crushes it in his fist. And as soon as that happens, the Mechanical Master taps out. And everyone's like, I don't know how to feel about this one. This is pretty weird.
Is machines getting injured? Injures him? I don't get it. Like,
afterward, there is an ad for Mass Effect Andromeda, and then we have the Amazon.
Nice.
What's your entrance like when you're going into your match? Tell us about this.
You hear the beginning of Welcome to the Jungle, and, like, fog surrounds the room, and then she comes, like, she's going to swing in above the stage and just drop down.
Oh, you're doing the stage.
Put her fist up in the air.
Well, when they have to do a promotion, your theme music is going to get changed to Raw by Katy Perry. You know that.
No, I feel like
you've got it timed where like you hit the stage, you put your fists up, and then they're like, "Jungle, welcome to the jungle."
Obviously, that's what happens.
Yeah. So maybe you're like rocking out to your theme music, and then suddenly the music drops out, and the lights all come back up, and the spotlights are going wild everywhere. There's like red, blue, green spotlights, and then they all focus up on the front of the stage. And there's like the walkway down in the big screen, but then like the floor opens up in front of the walkway, and like one of those freight elevators brings up Magical Michael, who's standing with his butt to the audience, and all of the lights are glittering off of this rhinestone packed boxer briefs he's wearing. And then he just turns around and is just like, and keeps doing like sexy poses the whole way up. He'll like walk 2 feet and then do a new pose. There are people, men and women both, who are like having him sign stuff and trying to get like selfies with him, and he's just like, Magical Michael, magical, have a magical day, everybody. Yeah, he gets up on the stage and he holds out his hand, and like someone tosses him a microphone and it lands perfectly in his cupped hand, and he's like, oh hey Amazon, how's it going? I saw you take down Ripper last month, but I just wanted to say, you're about to have, and the entire crowd's like, a magical day! A magical day.
I love that he's rescuing a woman and the hell beat out of him, I hope.
Yeah, so this is...
Please kick his ass, Cotton.
Yeah, we're live here. You've got momentum. He's like, come at me, broette. And gesturing for you to do whatever you want here. So let's talk about it.
I want to quickly jump up on the ropes and just elbow drop him if I can.
Okay.
Elbow drop him to the ground.
Yeah.
Start off real strong.
So let's see here. You're just literally like, boing, boom, you're Mario-ing him.
Yes. Instantly, just...
It's totally a springboard off the middle of the ropes. Wah!
Yeah.
No one sees that coming.
I feel like you're definitely doing something here. You're doing a wrestling move, right? But I think you're doing it with look. Would you say that this is a signature thing that you do normally? Or is this executing a difficult maneuver?
I think it's one of her normal moves.
Okay. All right.
So it's just look or...
Yeah, this is something you do a lot, demonstrating your high-flying ability. Roll plus look.
The Koopa Cracker.
Was that the 9 there?
Yeah.
I may have missed it. Perfect. Excellent. Let's talk about that. Yeah, you get to pick one. You retain control and transition into the next sequence, or you give your opponent control and gain plus one momentum.
I want to gain another momentum.
Excellent. So as you're gaining the momentum, we see running down to the stage, late for their audience participation announcer, is Crash, who was supposed to be at the table but is late. So Crash, you're announcing with James Jives, and Jives is like, joining me at the table is Crash Williams. Crash, how have you been doing all of that Vicodin? I definitely did not sell you.
He's sitting there, he's got sunglasses on as well. He's like, they're like blackout ones. He's like, I'm good.
What do you think's going on in this match? I thought that, really, Magical Michael looked like he was in a strong position to open, but Kaya just jumped right in there.
Magical Mike's stupid.
Okay, then, back to the ring. I'm sorry, which one did you pick? Kaya?
I got a momentum.
All right,
handed,
give control to Magical Michael. Yeah, so...
He's clearly zoned out as fuck, by the way, if that wasn't obvious.
So, Michael, as you, like, hit him and you knock him down, he rolls out of the ring and goes to pick up the microphone he dropped earlier and walks around the outside, and he's like, oh, hey, guys. Hey, Bay, what's up, Abigail? Just want to say, Pelican Town, is it the greatest city in America? I don't know. Why don't you tell me? And everyone's like, yeah, Pelican. fucking town. And he's like, that's right, Stardew Valley looking at you. Everybody's got
can
a
we
grandpa.
Cut him?
You got a grandpa? Seemingly like you got a grandpa.
Crash is looking for the audio switches behind the desk to see if there's that mic somewhere on one of the panels.
Yeah. So like, maybe we're doing the picture-in-picture thing again of, like, you trying to...
And there's, like, a board of, like, switches. He's like, no, like, a light goes off, another light goes... No, microphone, the music plays, no. He's just flicking switches trying to find that microphone on the soundboard.
Yeah, so Magical Mike... I'm sorry, we got a Magical Michael scrambles up
full
the
tile.
Side of the ring and gets on top of the ropes and does the magic missile. Which is where
yes.
he just does like a spear from the ropes to knock into Kaya. And as with all moves of this type, the two of you have to work together to do it right. Like, if this was real, you would both be greatly injured. But, like, you roll back with it so you don't get hurt. And as he's got you tackled, he's like, okay, you ready to do the next sequence?
Sure.
All right, what do you want to do? And as you're umming, he's like, ah, stay down there, Amazon. The only thing you're the queen of is the dirt.
Like, okay. I love the idea that I turned off the lights when you jumped, so he magic missiled the darkness.
Oh, no, they didn't do that.
No, I know. All
right, I want to kick you off my chest right now.
All right, let's do it. And he hands you control of the match back.
I just want to kick him straight up, like both feet, just kick
all
him
right,
off.
All right, so, yeah. You kick him, like, in the abdomen, and he's pushing off the ground at the same time, and he, like, froggers into the air. And he's just like, boy! Yeah, what are you doing from there? He's in midair, you're, like, on the ground. We're in slow-mo here.
While he's in the air, I'm gonna try to get up on the ropes again. And then try to do a backflip off of him and land on him.
Oh, boy. Yeah.
That
sounds to me
that?
Like you're doing something difficult, dangerous, and demanding. Would you say that's true? Or are you executing another signature move?
Nah, that sounds dangerous.
All right, let's roll plus work.
Because you got to run to make this look good, because otherwise he's laying there too long, so...
Yeah.
Go do the jump up to the ropes thing.
Oh, whoops.
Where's the Mountain Dew? Mountain Dew doesn't sponsor the show anymore. JoJo Corporation does. All right, cool, a 9.
Nice.
That's awesome. It's awesome.
Yeah, so what do you want to do here? You get to pick... Actually, we have to crash. Crash, you get to give your audience a pick up on this, right? You get to do the announcing, and if you want to, you can bump this up. Or you can
I'm trying to think.
Later.
Yeah, he will. He'll look at her and be like, that's awesome, and he'll start clapping on thing. Like he's sitting back, all like zoned up. He's just clapping the as she's flying through the air, just as like a nod of gratification.
James Jives is just like, that was incredible. Look at how high you flew there, and oh no, Kaya just backflipped onto him, and with the knee right in those pectoral muscles. Oh man, look at that glistening oil there, ladies and gentlemen. Really, just fine physique on Magical Michael. Using the power of Crash, you have gone from a 7 to 9 to 10 plus. What would you like to pick?
Using his zoned out appreciation.
Is that feats of strength or?
It's actually on the next page down. It's the block called wrestling on the left hand side.
Oh, okay, gotcha. I'll gain a heat.
Okay, you gain a heat with Magical Michael. Excellent.
And then I'm gonna grab a mic real quick. Out of nowhere.
Of course. That's exactly how this works.
I'll throw you one. Hand goes up, just chuck it.
And then I'll say, I'll show you who's your queen. And I'll try to pin him. Can I try to pin him?
Yeah, you can go for your finishing move. Before you do, I reveal to you that the winner of the match is the Amazon.
So yeah.
You definitely need to nail this finishing move. Tell us what this finishing sequence looks like.
All right. So she normally swings between like two ropes like grabs hold of him and swings her legs between him and kicks him. But since he's already gonna on the ground, she's just gonna do like a little flip in the air and land straight on his back. And I'm gonna, it's called Bow to Your Queen, because she normally kicks them and makes them look like they're bowing. And she's gonna stand on him.
This sounds incredibly painful and humiliating.
It is, that's awesome. I'm so glad. Please roll good.
What do I roll for the finishing move?
Finishing move is flat 2. Plus 0. You need to rely on your momentum in order to carry this one.
Bam!
Wow, amazing. Yes, you rolled a 10. So good.
Yeah.
What does that get you with your particular finishing move? For your gimmick, right? Each one has its own finishing move. Yes. A high flyer. On a 10 plus, you hit your finisher clean. You gain plus 1 audience. Cool. Mark that up.
Cool. Mm-hmm.
You also... Nope, you get nothing else from that. Good enough. Plus 1 audience is still big.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
Yeah. So you jump up to 3. If you hit 4, you're top of the card. Yeah. So... what's it like after the match? Why don't you narrate for us what happens afterwards? And then Crash can cut in with some commentary. Oh, you want to do the commentary now?
No, go ahead.
Okay.
After the match, she just kind of stands up on the ropes and puts a fist in the air and see if the crowd will cheer for her.
See if the... well, of course they're going to cheer for you, right? Audience,
and then there's an,
let's ask audience at home, are you cheering for her? Let us know in chat right there.
I want to give him someone to boo for. I'm going to run in here in, with a chair in the back as she's celebrating.
Are you doing the run-in move?
Yes.
Wow. Okay, go for it.
He's trying to sell his heel gimmick. He runs from the announce table with a chair and hits her in the back as she's celebrating up on the turnbuckle.
Monster.
Yeah. What's run-in with? It's not interrupt, is it? No. Oh, run in, there you go. Roll with plus heat, and I get wave of plus 1, right? So. Sorry, go try and be a bad guy.
Yeah. The worst guy, more like.
Gets a 7.
Yeah, let's talk about that. What are you going to pick?
The list is... sorry, flipping tabs. Run-in on 7-9.
Progress, roll plus heat.
Has potential, you gain 1 momentum.
Has potential, you gain plus 1 momentum.
And the target picks
up. Kaya, you get to pick one of the 3 options from the run-in move, which in the general move sheet is on the first page, upper right-hand corner. So, let's see here. The unkillable Crash Williams has 2 heat with Amazon now. The Queen of Mean.
I like it.
What do you want to do?
I get to pick one of the run-in?
Yes. He ran in on you, and you get to pick one. You attack him in the ring, your interference doesn't change the match, or your interference doesn't change the result.
I don't want him to change the result.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, he couldn't anyway.
All right, Crash, your interference doesn't change the result, but their opponent comes after you for interfering in their business. It's a new match for Crash Williams and Kaya, the Amazon Queen, right now in the ring. James Jives is literally standing up shouting, and that's when Ripper, how do you come down to audience, participate, be the announcer for this match?
Oh, I was... no, I'm not going to... I was thinking about doing a run-in myself, but...
you can do that right now.
Do it.
You can run in.
I'm sorely tempted, but I think it might be a little too early for that, and it'd ruin the drama that's building up here. So, Jeff Johnson comes down wearing a sport coat and a black t-shirt and sporting some shades of Zone.
James Johnson. And he just comes strolling down. Jeff Johnson, everybody! Jeff Johnson is joining me at the table! Jeff Johnson, I heard you're now the Vice President of Operations over at Joja Corporation's Pelican Town branch.
That's right, Tom. They can't seem to keep promoting me fast enough, it seems.
What are your thoughts about this match that's brewing right now? Crash and Kaya going at it in the ring.
Well, Crash is showing his stereotypical cowardice in attacking Kaya with a chair in the back there. It's probably the only way that he's going to be able to get any form of momentum in this match whatsoever, because we know that she can do things that he just can't do anymore.
I love your glasses.
You have done something underhanded. If you want to use your heel move and use two momentum, you can activate that.
Chad, I know his name isn't Tom. I just will always refer to him as Tom.
You should have seen the inspector's game where I referred to everybody by the wrong name. It was so hard getting their name wrong every time.
You mean the game I was in? Yeah, that was interesting.
The game you're in. I was constantly giving people the wrong name, and I kept wanting to say the right name.
Spend two momentum to gain. I only have two, so I'm going to keep my momentum and not activate the move.
Okay, all right. I feel like Crash is definitely in control of the match as it begins, so why don't you tell us what's happening here?
Yeah, so he hits her with the chair, and like she falls and gets back up, and then we get the call that it's a match, and actually the ref pulls the chair out of his hands. And he sort of... He's completely changed from his chilled out on the desk sort of attitude. And he's sitting there, and they're looking at each other, squaring off against the thing, and then he's just going to run in and try for a flying knee straight across the ring. He's just charging in recklessly.
Oh, man. All right. What kind of move do you think this is? I mean...
Something he's not good at.
It sounds like it could be a feat of strength.
I honestly think it would be work, because it's just running and trying to attack someone.
All right, let's do this then.
Which is awful.
Yeah. Throwing Kaya across the ring, trying to prove that you're the true king of the jungle.
Yeah, that's totally what he's trying to prove. My work is zero, so let's roll with that.
Live audience, I need to know right now who you want booked to win this match, because I had no idea what's happening. Let me know your thoughts.
Got an 8.
Crash. Tell me what kind of options you want to pick for this underhanded underdog move where you run up and throw Kaya across the ring.
Yeah. So we'll go with... Man, why is this annoying to find?
That's right. I'm sorry. Actually, Ripper gets to do his announcing. And might
if he wants
up.
To, yeah. He won't piss me off.
What's that?
Yeah, so you get to do your announcing of this match. You get to hype it up. And if you want to, as the announcer, you can give a boost to both players once.
Okay.
To up their die roll. So yeah, you see Crash run in and like throw Kaya across the ring after the two of them had like beat on each other for a little while. And James is like, "Are you seeing this? Are you seeing this? This is incredible right here. What are your thoughts?"
My God, Tom, I've never seen any larger act of cowardice before in my life. Crash just keeps it up. He's not willing to face off with this woman one-on-one properly. He just won't let up and give her a chance to get her own 2 feet underneath her.
What are your thoughts about the rumors that Crash and Kaya have been dating behind the scenes?
Well, if they were dating behind the scenes, Tom, I think this would probably be pretty much him breaking up with her at this point.
All right.
I say, so it's 79, pick one. I'll give over control and gain one momentum.
All right. Kaya, you are in control now.
Up to three. I want to get up on the ropes again and then try to, like, jump off and kick him in the face.
Going for a drop kick.
Yeah. I feel like
she's going for something risky here, Tom.
This is literally the same thing you did earlier. So, yeah, I feel like you're rolling with plus look here. Ripper, you want to give us some feedback?
Yeah, look at that signature move as she dives off of the post there straight onto Crash's head. What a fantastic move. Have you ever seen anything like that, Tom?
Name is Still Jives. James Jives. No jive. And I have seen something like that. We just saw it moments ago when Kaya hit him in the face. And then again on this replay. And then, like, they do the PIB instant replay. So while the two of them are still wrestling, they do, like, Kaya in slow motion, like, brrrr. And Crash is like, no.
Awesome.
I could watch that all day, Tom. What a beautiful move.
What do you want to have happen here, Kaya?
I want to gain momentum and hand over the...
All right, so you're up to three momentum. Crash, you are in full operational control of this match.
Yeah, so she hits me with the drop kick, and we sort of take it in a roll, and we'll sort of do the trade punches back and forth until we'll do, like, the chest knockdown, so she's on the ground, and then he's going to go duck the ropes and go for a springboard backflip moonsault. So that should be interesting. Let's try that.
What is that? I mean, you're saying words.
So it would be...
Describing.
Yeah, I'm saying wrestling. So a springboard is where you jump up to, into the middle of the rope rather than going to the turnbuckle. Using it to bounce off, and then he's going to sort of ultra flip, which is a backwards flip, landing face down on the down person.
Okay. Yeah.
It's a real thing, and it's really hot.
Yeah, let's see the roll, and then let's have our announcers talk about
this. So what do I get to roll with on that one?
This feels like look, right? To some extent. Okay. It sounds like it's a signature.
Well, it's a showy, it's a big showy thing, and it's the type of style he
sets in. So here's my question. That's how he plays. Is this look, or is this... Oh, you're not working together on it. Yeah, it's definitely look of some kind. Yeah. Right? You guys can roll heat with each other if you were to do a series of moves like where you have to work together to make it look good.
Well, basically, so he hit her with the chair. They do, like, normal moves. She's hit him with a drop kick, and she's a high flyer, so now he's got to do his high spot, try and make something out of it.
All right, let's do some look. Most couples break up with a cell phone, but Crash prefers furniture.
Roll an 11.
Yeah, let's talk about that. What do you want to pick here? You got some good picks. You hit it great. You retain control and pick one.
Yeah, hit it great. Go hit one. Sorry, I have lost that page for a second. This flipping stuff. Okay, so pick one on the look thing.
Plus two momentum.
God damn it.
Plus one heat with your opponent.
Let's take the heat.
All right.
Sounds good.
Ripper has two heat with Amazon now.
Crash. Boom.
Excellent. You are still in control, Crash.
Yeah. Wouldn't it be I have two heat with her, like Ripper again, like you said?
I keep saying Ripper, don't I? Boom.
Yeah, as long as it's on the paper, fine.
The worst. Actually, it looks like you have three heat with her now.
Yeah. One for starting, one for hitting her with the chair, and then one for that.
Yeah, you're about to hit that four. Okay. You're in command of the match. Let's talk about it. What do you want to do?
He's going to be underhanded, and seeing that he's got her down for a chance, he's going to try and go for a finish. Try and get this done, because he's in two matches.
And that's when you get the call over the announcement board that Kai is scheduled to win this little run-in that you've done.
Yep.
So what's the deal? You gonna break kayfabe and keep going for it, or are you going to let Kaya take you down?
That's an interesting choice. He's pissed off at management, so he's going to try and break kayfabe and go for the finish.
You're a monster. All right. I feel
I'm thinking my playbook has something about that, actually.
You have. So that's not actually break kayfabe move? That's
no,
a
it's...
heel move where you spend two momentum and do something underhanded. I think
that my finishing move has something about it. I'm not sure, but whatever.
Well, let's find out.
Oh, no, that's another move. Sorry, that's if I took the money make a move. That's fine.
All right, so
I didn't take it.
You're going to need to spend two momentum
and
pick one of the following. And it sounds like you're going to win the match.
Yeah.
Right? Tell us.
Yep.
Tell us. Actually, Kaya, I want to know from your perspective. You're getting over your ear that they're like, all right, Kai, it's time for you to win the match. Time to bring this in. And then Crash just goes nuts. What are you thinking?
Oh, she's pissed.
Yeah, so I'm down to one momentum. And do I need to roll on it, or does it happen?
No, it happens automatically. You don't land your finishing move, you just win the match.
Yeah, so what he'll do is he'll go to the top rope, and then he's like, they were scheduled to win, and he'll stumble on his finish, and he'll do like a different, like an awkward different high-flying move and hit it and pin on that, rather than the actual finishing move everyone was expecting him to go for.
Yeah.
It didn't look anywhere near as good as it should.
What are your thoughts here, Ripper, looking at the underhanded methods of Crash?
My God, bullying. Crash Williams has no shame. None whatsoever. Right on the turn of Kaya making Magic Mike look like a magic moron, Crash comes out of nowhere and slams her into the dirt. What do you think, Tom?
Still jives. James jives. Crash Williams, everybody. Crash Williams is the number one contender for this match. Does a real asshole, everyone. And everyone's like, boo, we hate you, Crash. Go back to the reality where you belong.
Yeah, he's rolling on the ground like after the move, and he's like, okay, at least they're booing. This is like something's working.
That's right, Tom. He's a first-class asshole.
He's going to, as soon as he gets composure, he's going to sort of do the stumble out of the ring and sort of half run, hobble out up the ramp to get out of there. Because he's got two more matches.
You better run.
I know. Good thing that not the Ripper is down here and he can't get me backstage as I go back there.
Yeah, so they play a little audience promo piece of... It's like a weathered, grandfatherly farmer somewhere from the Midwestern of America sitting on a stool in front of what's an obvious green screen of like a cornfield in the background. And he's like, in my day, America had respect for the agricultural industry. And Monsanto can make America great once again. We're partnering with the Joja Corporation to bring the finest seeds and growth hormone products to Pelican Town. Vote yes on referendum 31B tax 72XY and help bring Monsanto to Pelican Town. Have you considered voting against Mayor Lewis? And then it like screen wipes to the next match, which according to my notes is the Ripper versus the unkillable Crash Williams.
Oh, good.
Crash, you're coming in first. Ripper gets to do what he wants for his come-in, so, yeah.
Yeah, Crash does his entrance, and I wonder how that goes.
Are you supposed to have, like, come onto the screen and you're literally just, like, staying in the ring?
No, it would be real awkward. He'll duck out, and then, like, the music will start, and he'll come back out and do the full pose and the pyro and everything and walk back down. He was backstage for, like, 20 seconds. And he clearly looked way more exhausted than he was supposed to. It's, like, the cool shot where they're walking down the ramp and it, like, comes in close, but he's already sort of covered in sweat and panting a bit because he was literally just in a match rather than looking sort of tough as he was meant to.
Yeah. Ripper.
And then he's just going to wait in the middle of the ring doing the look around thing. Like,
as soon as he starts looking around in the ring, all of the lights throughout the entire stadium go completely black. All you see is little camera flashes and everything like that. Maybe a baby crying off in the corner somewhere or something. Some hushed murmurings. And then there's sound of Ripper's theme song, which is Fuel from Metallica, the S&M version. And right when it builds up after the intro, the lights flash on and Ripper standing with his arms crossed directly behind Crash.
He's doing the camera angle where he's like really little and you can like see you behind him.
Just this like giant towering mass just right behind him, and then Crash turns around and Ripper just starts going to work.
Alright. So like, yeah, while that's happening, James Jives is escorting Kaya down to the announcer table. And the whole time he's just like showing her his collection of fan art of people that he's seen in Pelican Town. He's like, oh, Pat, look at this. She eats rocks. They call her Abigail. She's so stupid. She eats rocks all the time. Look here. This is his kid, Sebastian. Man, he's got like some flock of seagulls hair. Anyway, now announcing this match, it's the queen of the Amazon, Kaya. Kyle, what are your thoughts going into this match? Crash Williams just dealt you a pretty serious beatdown after your victory over Magical Michael. What are your thoughts on this match as Crash Williams faces down with the Ripper one more time?
Oh, the Ripper's definitely going to rip him in half.
Another salty set of commentary by Kaya. Let's go directly to the ring right now. Ripper, you're in control. Tell us what's happening.
I didn't know the Amazon River was a salt river.
Start off with a lot of just, you know, light face pounding, like the standard 6-inch punches that wouldn't do anything to wet tissue paper.
And like the fling over the top one where it hits the top of your head and just goes over the top.
And at one point, after a few seconds, Ripper scoops up Crash into a fireman's carry and is going to try and jump and then land on top of him down onto the mat.
Samoan drop, I believe, is the real term for
Crash,
that move.
Crash, are you working with him on this?
Yes. I was booked in this match.
Yeah, I think you should work heat on this one, Ripper. It sounds like the two of you are working together to execute an amazing and memorable sequence.
He was actually meant to be in this match. He impromptu'd the other one to try and get his heel stuff over when it wasn't working. But he's going with booking for now on this one. He doesn't want to piss them off anymore, Jesus. Yeah.
So this would be work, would it not?
No, it's heat, because the two of you are working together specifically.
So what do we have, plus one on each other? I think that's right.
Yep. Boom. Boom.
Yeah. The way these matches is described, this is clearly the slicker match that was actually planned out, and we're actually doing the right thing.
So, Kaya, what are your thoughts here? You literally watch Crash get the shit kicked out of him, and then he gets lifted off of the ground, and then, like, behind the back, elbow drop from behind kind of thing. Dives is just like, it is just, wow. I haven't seen that since I was in the hospital for the sixth time.
They don't call him Ripper the Monster for nothing.
What are your thoughts here, Kaya? I just want to know if you want to put over Ripper's move and bump him up to a 10+.
I do. I'm going to say that takes an extraordinary amount of strength, what he's doing right there. Not every wrestler can do something like that. Crash sure can't.
No, we cannot. And in the camera angle, it cuts out my leg so we don't see that I was going up with it, like doing the jump with it.
He was jumping.
Which is what you're meant to do. That's what you do. That's what you're meant to do in real wrestling. Look real.
Oh, man. PJ Salt emote all day long. Yeah. So, Ripper, you hit a 10 plus there with that boost. What do you want to do?
Okay, so this is under
the. You retain control and.
I'm going to gain plus one heat.
Okay.
Nice.
So Ripper is now at two heat with the unkillable Crash Williams.
Okay. It's an unkillable, not uninjurable. Definitely not that.
All right. And I will transition from there into throwing him into the ropes so I can do a clothesline.
Ooh, big power move. Man. I love it.
It's like an Irish whip, but with way more body mass being thrown into it.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, that one is definitely going to be work. Straight up.
Run into this tree log that is my arm.
I almost wonder if that's power. Are you putting him at risk? Like, if
no, it's that's a standard wrestling move. It's just he's a big guy.
All right.
It's far too brilliant match for that. And this is, we're still going on the scripted sequence.
Yeah, Kaya, what are your still thoughts here? Jives is just like, wow, huge hit by Ripper there. Just amazing strength from this guy. There's a reason they call him the Ma. Oh no, you rolled a six.
There's a reason they call him the Ma. Oh no.
I'm going to burn a point of momentum on that.
All right.
Bump it to seven.
Which, let's see, does that still fall under wrestling, or is there something specific?
No, still wrestling.
Okay.
Yeah, Jives, literally takes a microphone and shoves it in Kaya's face and is like, thoughts here, looking at Crash bleeding on the floor.
What are you thinking?
She's just going to push the mic away from him. I'm trying to watch the match here, man.
Yeah, so after I clothesline him and he flattens down on the mat, I immediately transition over into an elbow drop.
Oh, I'm getting pounded.
Would you say this is a signature move for you? Is this something that you're well known for? Or is this still just power over it? Sorry.
This one, given my great size and bulk, this is something that, you know, a lot of people really don't want to see have happen to anyone at all, ever.
Yeah, it's the same as, like, the big splashes and stuff, all the big guys. It's like, yeah, I don't want that landing on me ever.
Yeah, so how do you feel you're going to go about this?
So I'm definitely...
Still not as bad as Rikishi.
The butt drop?
That, like, broke a dude's, like five ribs on a guy when he couldn't hold his weight one time. Like, not good. He weighed a lot.
And I think this one would definitely fall under power because he's putting some oomph behind it.
Yeah, you're actually going to put Crash at risk here. May literally kill him with this elbow.
He's unkillable.
Like a bug.
He's unkillable.
Oh, snap. I don't think you have any momentum left, do you?
No, actually, this will work great. So Crash can turn it over and.
All right. Yeah. On a botch, so you get countered. You give one momentum to your opponent. You won't have any, and they take immediate control of the match. Crash Williams gets one momentum anyway, bringing him back to two. Yeah. What do you want to do here, Crash? Actually.
Okay, so I see him.
Jives is just
leaning
like, oh no! Oh. Oh, look at, he hit himself in the elbow there. Look, he's got that, the funny elbow thing. I forget
the
what it's
bone.
Called. I'm so drunk right now.
Funny elbow thing?
Yeah. So what we'll do is, to make this look better, as I probably cowered out of this move as he's coming down, like, that's bad, that's bad, that's bad. So he does, like, a leg scissors, like, he puts his legs around him and makes it look like he tripped him down, rather than just rolling out of the way. And then he'll, like, push him out under the ring so he's outside. And then he'll do straight Jeff Hardy, run against the opposite rope, run back, and jump over all the ropes to the outside, going for a flying punch, which he calls the jump the gun, hoping that this actually lands and that Ripper catches him.
That's a signature move then, right?
Yeah, that definitely is. Yeah, that's one of his actual moves. He goes for a flying Superman punch to the outside, over the ropes.
No, I mean,
yeah, what is signature roll with? I'm sorry.
I think it's look, right?
Cool. My actual good stat. Please catch me. Yes. I got it.
All right. Kaya, you could put him over on this move if you wanted to, or completely ignore it. Okay.
No.
Yeah, so he reverses this situation, and Jives is just hands up on the table. He's like, oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, what is happening here? We're seeing a reversal. Kaya, are you seeing what I'm seeing?
If you're seeing this reversal, then yeah. I mean, we are looking at the same match.
Hi, Queen of the Amazon, everybody. Look at Crash. Oh, man, that's a huge hit on Ripper. Can the Ripper take it? Who knows? Crash, what option would you like to take?
I'm currently scrolling. Kayfabe Heat, promo, blah, 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 run in, audience. God damn it. Why did this book laid out like this?
So it's okay. Plus one momentum and give control, or retain control and transition into the next sequence.
We'll retain control and transition.
All right. So here's the bad news, is that as you transition to the next sequence, you get the call from creative. Your booking is that Ripper wins the match.
Yeah, of course he is. So we that's perfect. We turn this into the plucky young kid match where he beats me down. I come back and do some great moves, but he'll still end up losing in the end.
I mean, you are a heel and you have two momentum. You could just win the match anyway.
I'm not doing that to creative twice. They'll kill me. So we get up from the outside and I'll push him in, and then I'll go up to do my finishing move, but he will roll and I will just land, and then I'll hand over. As I'm laying helpless on the floor.
All right, Ripper.
Actually, Ripper catches him.
Yeah, go for the catch. Even better.
And then still holding on to him, stands up.
Oh, no. What's happening? Oh, it looks like a reversal.
And then throws him down onto the mat in front of him.
I love the idea that I was doing my finishing move, so I was doing a front flip, and he just sort of caught me as the feet came down and just powerbombed him down. That would be a memorable move. I'm saying that's super memorable finish. That's crazy.
So you get to roll 2d6 plus nothing. Unless you're timing on momentum, that, which you don't.
Seriously, the timing on that.
It's 2d6 plus finish. Nothing. It's a finish.
It's just
move.
A finish.
They're all plus nothing.
But you can spend on it.
Boom! 8.
That'll work.
Good stuff. Yeah. So what does your finishing move let you do?
No idea.
finishing move. 7 and 9. They make you work for it. You get to pick one of these. They showcase your strength, and you both gain +1 momentum, or they're unwilling to take your finisher and flee the ring, gain +1 heat. So does Crash cowardly scatter away, or does he make you look real good by being like,
We've done it all by the book so far, so would it probably be a clean finish would make sense if you were just doing a flat match.
But a lot of cowardly Crash.
Well, yeah, we have, so it's up to him. He gets to pick.
I think really we continue with the cowardly Crash.
Okay. So describe how Crash is unwilling to let you slam him into the floor and scamper
well,
away.
Well, more like I slam him into the floor and then I reach out for a chair so I can perform my tombstone finisher.
And then he rolls out
of the ring and just runs away.
Ladies and gentlemen, victory by disqualification. The Ripper!
Can I throw Crash back in the ring? I want to see him get the finisher.
You could chase him. It's on the other side of the ring.
Maybe like you leap over the top of the announcer table and chase him around the ring for a little while. For no apparent reason.
Perfect.
Oh god, I got another match, don't I? Jesus.
Yeah. And that's when.
That's why he ran. That's totally why he ran.
While Ripper is still in the ring and Kaya is chasing Crash around, the lights go out, and then there's like two orange light spotlights that over to in front of the big screen TV, and that's when our Donald Trump impersonator Julius Orange comes out. He's wearing a business suit, like blue everything with like an orange tie, and underneath his like suit, he's wearing an orange old style wrestling leotard type thing. And he comes out and he just is like, "Let's make Pelican Town great again." And everyone's like, "Yeah, Pelican Town, Julius Orange." And he's just like, "Yeah, referendum, everybody. We gotta just keep Mayor Lewis out of Pelican Town, Stardew Valley. Remember Grandpa. Grandpa, everyone. Okay. Yeah, let's do this thing." And he like walks down to the ring. And he's
I've done the whole thing.
Listen, I need Crash. Gotta stop this. Don't worry. I'll like break him for you, okay? Pelican Town great again.
I like the fact Crash is gone. He's done the duck into the audience, disappear, like helped by security. Like he's done his getaway, like the booked getaway. And then he comes and does his entrance again. Like he comes into the ring and it's like, "Where's Crash?" And then the lights flash and everyone's like, "Ah, again," the third time. And a big spot and then the big columns go up and he's doing the pose.
James, ladies and gentlemen, I just had word that at least one audience member has actually had a seizure from Crash Radio's entrance being displayed multiple times tonight. And everyone's like, "Boo, we hate you, Crash!"
Someone throws a foam brick at Crash. Yeah,
right? It looks real, but it's like one of the Planet audience members. They throw it at you, and everyone's like, "Yeah, hit him with another one!"
And he like gives the guy the finger, like, you know, into the audience and stuff. Tears someone's sign in half, because that's classic.
There's someone in half. Yeah, maybe it's like it's a magical mic sign, and you just rip it in half. And the guy's like, "Oh man, I really like that sign. I worked really hard on that."
Yeah. Yeah, he'll go into the ring for this match. He looks like crap now.
So yeah, Julius Orange is just ripping his suit apart. He's like, argh, argh, argh,
argh. Yeah, he's going to do the exact Jeff Hardy contemplate thing where he's sort of sitting in the lower turnbuckle, like catching his breath, like just waiting in the corner for the match to start.
Ripper.
He actually needs to catch his breath.
I feel like it'd be suitable for the actual Ripper to be the announcer for this match. You down with that?
Sure, I can do that.
So, yeah, when you go to sit down, James Jones is like, ladies and gentlemen, I am joined tonight by a very rare spectacle. And, like, all the music goes down and the lights go really dim. The Ripper will be joining me at the announcing table. It's been almost 2 years since he sat next to me. Ripper, how are you?
James.
The Ripper, everybody. The Ripper. Let's
take a look at the
audience real quick while we wait for this match to get warmed up. And everybody's, like, doing the audience cam thing, and there's a sign out that says Queen of Bean for President, and there's another one that says Long May She Reign, and there's someone else just holding up like a fan art picture of Kaya over their head, and they're like, me.
She's the one baby face on the card, so who has a little.
I want to point out though that the Ripper is sitting there wearing his trunks and his mask and his sport coat. And
yeah, but I love the idea that when you sat down, you do the exact same motions as when you did your other one. Like, you still, like, took your hand across the stomach to hold, like, your coat down that's not the same coat, but you sit in exactly the same position with the same life. It's like, how do they not pick it's the same guy?
It's Superman and Clark Kent.
Yeah. It's the dreadlocks. I just can't tell the difference.
Crash, I feel like Julius Orange is in control of this match. Would you agree?
Yeah. Either that or I was meant to be and I fucking botched because he's exhausted, not paying attention.
What happened?
So he's got to do something.
Julius holds out his hand to give you a handshake.
He goes up like he's already hurt. He's like, and nods and shakes, I guess.
So he does the double handshake that you see some people, especially politicians, do, where he like grabs your hand up and it's nice and warm. And then he's
how much momentum do I have? I've got two. I can spend it, do a heel move, and just drop to my knees and punch him in the groin.
Yeah,
off the handshake.
You could instantly win this match if you wanted to, or leave someone helplessly lying on the floor. Is that what you want to do?
So he does the handshake, and I immediately drop down to my knees and just do the like the
do a
classic,
Johnny Cage.
Yeah. Just,
oh, are like you a, actually doing full a Johnny rip. Cage where you do a split?
No, because he's probably couldn't do that at this point. He just drops straight to his knees and just brings up the other hand.
All right, you drop and, zero momentum.
Which is bad, I know.
Yeah, and
but,
you instantly win the match.
Yeah.
Well, no, you leave your opponent lying helplessly on the floor. Are you going to, like, pin him? Or are you just going to walk off and let him win by disqualification?
Can I crawl up and pin him for free, or do I have to, like...
Yeah, no, you can just literally be like... Bleh.
Yeah, so he's on the... He does that, and everyone's, like, probably booing as the guy, and they're both laying on the floor, and he does, like, the one-arm crawl and puts one hand over the shoulders. Wait,
really? I don't even know why we called you down here. It looks like Crash breaking the rules again. Can anyone stop this man?
I do a run-in.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, good.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead and roll.
Like,
plus
still can, wearing the sport
can
coat.
Can you turn over the announcer's table? Because, like, Kaya jumped up over it. I ran around it because we're small guys. You're big. You just, like, push over the table and walk over it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Still wearing the sport coat just kind of sweeps the table aside.
Yeah. They're not very heavy.
You rip the mic off of Jives' face, and he struggles to, like, get one of the floor mics. He's like, ladies and gentlemen, I have no idea what's happening here. Ripper appears to be going after Crash Williams in the ring one more time. And then, like, Daft Punk's One More Time starts playing one more time. Yeah, got to celebrate.
I go do dive rolling in and then do the same style clothesline maneuver, the exact same clothesline maneuver.
As I'm getting up, you just do the same thing.
Just pick you up, throw him into
the
rope.
You're like Hulk Hogan. You have five moves that you just rotate between.
Yeah, roll plus heat, bro.
Which we actually have.
Let's see. What's my heat now? I gained heat off of him.
Yep.
Yeah, we're rolling big on that.
Good. Big Pelican Town, great again. Oh, shit!
Boom!
He's on the floor. Roll. On a 10 plus, it's a hot angle. You both gain plus one when heated with each other. And
oh my God.
You get to pick one from the 7 and 9 list there. So, the unkillable Crash Williams now has 2 with Ripper. Ripper has 4, and if you end this match while you still have 4, you're going to get an audience Ripper.
Let's see. So this is wrestling.
No, and Crash is trying so hard to make this heal.
Oh, this is running. Okay. Pick one, Fry. You tag them in the ring. I think my interference doesn't change the result of the match, but creative books the two of us in a match later on.
Yeah, so I still win with my underhanded move, but then they're like, you guys are going to fight.
Okay. But I just flat out laid him out in one hit and then just stormed off.
Okay, after he storms off, after we're done, after we're all still lying on the floor in a busted heap, he's going to grab for a mic and look to the audience, walking around like clutching himself. And he's going, you know what? You guys suck. You don't want a chant for me? That's fine. I still win. I'm still alive. Can't take you down. And he'll turn around and look at the jewelers and go, have fun. There's crushed oranges. And he's gonna walk off up the ramp.
Okay. Are you working the audience? Or
yes.
Or are you breaking?
Wait, I can also do. No, I was gonna actually do cheap heat.
Okay.
When you insult or praise an audience on their hometown, gain plus one moment.
I almost wonder if this is kind of promo in cheap heat, right? Because you're speaking your mind.
Yeah, it was just meant as like a... He's still trying his heel.
Well, I mean, you can cut a promo and get cheap heat at the same time.
Yeah, so roll on the... I get look for that, right? Yeah.
You get momentum real quick, bringing you back up to one.
Which is important.
Ripper, you now have 2 audience. Because you ended with 4 heat.
And I'll roll that audience. 7.
Well, let's see if the audience still hates you after this. 7 to 9.
They probably do. That's a good thing.
You get to pick one. What would you like to take?
I would like to take... I'll just do the gain another momentum.
All right. Yeah, people are behind it. They may not like you.
Love to hate him.
Yeah, they love to hate you. So, after a few more matches, we come down to, once again, Ripper versus Crash for the 3rd time tonight.
Oh, God.
So, James Jives is like, sitting in a chair. It's the only thing left at the announcer's area.
So, if I wrestled 3 matches plus an impromptu plus a run, so this is my 6th time, like, against an opponent tonight.
Yeah,
everyone's just hating on Crash, it seems.
James Jives pulls a chair for Kaya and is like, Kaya, good to see you back. It's Ripper versus Crash again for the 3rd time. Glad to have you here. Hope you're looking forward to this one.
Can I input two shirtless, like, African looking guys that come down to the ring and give her like a footstool to put her feet on while she's sitting there without a table?
Very well.
That would be amazing.
Please.
Sounds great.
I think that's something that should probably happen.
And then they stand next to it. They stand next to it with palm fronds.
Yeah,
with big fronds.
Yep. We're just going full ham into the complete corniness of this. Yeah, it's wrestling. I mean, wrestling does that, so.
Yeah, so. It's not even a clown move, it's just like a character move, you know. She's not making a fool of herself, it's just playing a character really strongly. Just going all in on it. Is this enough? Is there an upgraded version of this where they bring down pot plants as well?
Oh god! who's coming in first?
Crash is gone. He walked out again.
All right, Ripper.
Crawling almost this time.
Ripper actually does a normal style intro, playing the same Metallica Fuel song as he comes out onto the stage, his arms raised out wide.
Yeah.
Like a barbell in each hand with like clumsily written 1,000 pounds written on each one. And he throws them away and starts stalking down towards the ring.
Perfect. Crash, what does your intro look like? Same thing for like the fourth
time. And all the lights start flashing.
The audience is just like, boo. Oh, God.
And he comes out and does the pose and the silhouette with the flares on him, but it's like, it's clearly like struggling. Like, he's got like one arm up and he's like breathing heavy. And like, he ran down to the ring in his entrance, but he's like clearly like jogging, half jogging.
Someone shouts out and is like, I have kids to get home to, jerk.
Just be like, just into the crowd. He's just totally, he's going full bad guy.
So James Jive just is sipping on a Joja Blue that he pours into a red Solo cup, and then picks up like a bottle that's in a brown paper bag and pours into the cup. And it's like, Kaya,
wait,
what are your thoughts about match? That
I walk around to James Jive and I reach for the bottle.
Okay, you're gonna take some.
Yeah, I just do that in front of the whole
crowd. You're drinking it, and maybe you're acting like you're drunk.
Well, it's in a paper bag, right? Yep. So, and he hands it back, and he like does a really like annoying bad guy like false tip of a hat that isn't there to Kaya, and then rolls into the ring.
I'm gonna knock James Jeff's cup out of his hand angrily.
So James is just sitting there, he's done. He's just staring at his hand. Maybe he's like narrating that. He's like, ladies and gentlemen, Kaya, the queen of the jungle, has just knocked my cup of gin and juice out of my hand. I don't know what I'm feeling right now. It's so hard.
Maybe it's sober. You haven't felt that.
And I am. Jesus. Actually, AP, I'm going to actually use my addict move on this, where I'm clearly on something at this point.
Okay, tell us more.
He's taken repeated beatings today. So he's not just stumbly from, like, he's doing the wound, like, oh, I'm hurt miming, but he's actually clearly stumbling. Okay. And he probably didn't realize that bag was fake. Like, he was expecting alcohol and didn't get it.
You lose momentum, but you lose too real. Wow, that's brutal.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's a massive trade-off. But it's in character. That's what he would do. He'd actually be having to take painkillers backstage now as all his injuries are starting to flare up from just exhaustion.
Oh, boy. You have to roll real for all your non-gimmick moves?
Yeah.
Oh, you realize there's absolutely no way you can win at this point.
Yeah, I know.
All right, yeah. Audience, I would like to know who you would like scheduled to see this match, Ripper versus Crash. Let me know in chat right now.
Please schedule me to win so I can't do it.
Ripper, I feel like
break kayfabe and fail.
I feel like you definitely have control of the match at this point.
Oh, yeah.
Crash just stumbles in. Maybe he's drunk. You know. Maybe he's hot.
No, you can tell that he's not. His eyes are glassy. You can see him up close. You're definitely going to have to help him along this one. He's clearly not all there. You know, that's
like grab him, my big meaty hand on either side of his head, and I'm like trying to stabilize him a little bit.
Want to do some ring talk where you're like, you're right.
Start punching with like
bad selling. He's selling it badly.
Strikes and everything.
He's doing bad sells.
Everyone wants James Jive to win this match. That's not even
James Jive's running.
Yeah, you're just gonna pick him up and start punching him? I feel like this is definitely something that could hurt him, right? Like, this could legitimately hurt someone who's so totally messed up.
I thought
he
was just rolling real basic, like, shitty punches.
Is it just a fake punching you're doing work?
Yeah.
He's basically holding
trying
him out
to
with
give him
one
the chance to stabilize and get his head into it.
So I have a question. What is your relationship with Crash, like, behind the scenes right now?
For really, really.
Are you like, hey man, are you okay? Like, while you're punching him in the face, or are you like, get your shit together, son?
Oh no, I'm totally like, are you okay? Can you do this?
Just one more. Just walk us through it. Finish it. Pin. Leave.
Okay. Remember, just like how we practiced. You got this.
It's not 5 minutes and we're done. Not spending this time on this one.
Jesus Christ.
Like. There's stuff kicking in. He's literally like, you got like 5 minutes.
Dude, we're not going out tonight after this. I hope you realize.
It's fine. Collapse trailer.
I love how you guys have been punching each other for like 60 seconds.
It's a rest hold. That's a real wrestling thing where they're just like, and like headlocks, and they're just talking about the whole thing the whole time.
Make your roll, and then we'll hear from the Queen of the Jungle. Boom. Kaya.
Nice.
Jives is just like, oh, they are really mixing it up there. Ripper is just beating on Crash. Oh, my goodness. And I still don't have a drink. Kaya, what did you do to my drink? Why would you do that?
About the match, it looks like Ripper is getting his revenge for Crash cowardly running away earlier.
When James does have a drink, you're like, okay, I'm trying to watch the match. And now you're like, anyway, cut back to the match.
I love that Kai is also definitely not a company person and is out, like, to be the best. Because it's like, do you want to, like, make this look better for the show? Nah, no, I want to be better. Nope. Not a company girl. That's fine.
All right, Ripper, 7-9. What do you want to do?
Is Crash actually starting to look a little bit more composed by this point?
No. He's
wasting
the
whole time. Fading fast. He told you, you got 5 right. minutes. Till, like, this
I'm
shit
going to go into a full suplex.
Ooh,
to try and slam it.
Classic.
So you're retaining classic. Control?
Yeah.
All right.
Classic.
And I'm going to try and end the match early.
Oh, are you doing are you using your heal ability to... I don't know that you can. You don't have any momentum.
Oh.
Are you going to try to blow your finishing move right now?
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, the audience has booked Crash to win. And so as you begin your suplex, Crash, how do you reverse this?
Okay, so he goes up for the suplex and, like, Crash is, like, limp, so he doesn't, like, go up well and he has to, like, come back down. And he's just going to turn it into a DDT. So he's going to, like, as he's in the headlock, just drop back and drop his face into the floor.
Oh, snap. This is a gimmick move for you, so you do not have to roll addict on it. So.
Thank God.
You have a ton of momentum. There's very small chance that you can mess this up. You would yep. literally have to roll snake eyes.
Yes, that's exactly right. And watch me do it.
Watch me nip.
Let's do it.
Now watch me nay-nay.
Nice.
Okay, you want to blow any momentum on this, or you want to accept the roll as it stands? Also, you could prevail on Kaya to give you a putover and bump your roll up to a 10+.
There's no chance for that one. But he hit me with a chair.
It was trying to be a bad guy. It didn't hurt. You're okay. What I think I'll do is... No, I'm not going to blow it yet. I'm just going to take the roll as it stands.
Okay. All right. Tell us what option you want to take.
Is regain control one of the options on it? Sorry, retain control?
No, I mean, it's your finishing move, so your options are plus one.
If it's going to be finishing, then he'll do the DDT, and then he'll go to the top. And if it's finishing, I didn't know I was rolling with... That doesn't really make sense.
It's your finishing move, right? Because you rolled the match, you have to win.
Plus, I rolled with plus two, because you said it was signature.
Right. So yeah, you only have a 5. You want to throw 2 momentum in there?
Yeah, do that.
Okay, excellent. You get plus one audience, something goes wrong, you lose all momentum, and you get to choose. Your opponent no-sells it, lose one heat, you injure yourself, you injure them.
Let's do the no-sell, because it looks like crap.
So, Ripper, you're going in for this win. Maybe you're thinking, okay, it's time for me to finish what I did earlier. And suddenly booking is like, all right, let him win. Let Crash win. And you're just like, no. 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 And Crash is trying to DDT you, and you're like standing there like, I'm not going down. This isn't happening.
Yeah, so it's real shitty. It's just like, you're like, oh, fine, I'll go. And then like, oh, bumped, I'm out. Oh, no. That's what a no-sell is. It's like, you don't sell that it hurts or does anything. You just, it looks like shit.
Excellent. Cool. So wasted. You have jumped up to 3 audience. Perfect.
And now, he's going to try and stumble out of the ring, no celebration, and get backstage before everything hits, and he can no longer walk anymore. And he goes to Happy Place.
This is a really good place to take our break, right?
As Crash, like, is almost crawling up the ring, up the stairs to get backstage.
So, the next 2 hours when we come back, I want you to be prepared, live viewing audience, and also YouTube audience, just in your heart. Send me your energy, right? You can send me energy from the future and it will reach me in the past. Let me know what kind of matches you guys want to see. I mean, we have James Jives. We can put him in the ring if you want. Scowling Scotty Proper, the Mechanical Master, the Unkillable, Ripper, and Amazon Queen. Let me know what matches you want to see. You can do tag team. You can stipulate like cage match or something. When we come back, we're going to do some behind the scenes work. where we'll be talking not to the actor, we'll be talking to the actors, not the characters on the stage, but we'll be talking to them behind the scenes, trying to do some business dealing or maybe just trying to get some sleep. So we will be back in 6 minutes for the second half of our Wrestlecation. Boom.